Welcome back, guys. It is Zero Idea, and it is me, myself, Michael, and it is you, yourself, Jacob, and you, the best in the room, the coolest in the room, the prettiest in the room. Amanda is in the room doing the computer. Brent was very tired from the zoo today. He went there. He wasn't working, and he couldn't make it. So it's just us three here, and we want to give a quick shout out real quick to our patrons that make this possible. They're about to make a nice little upgrade to the room, and it's all thanks to them. It's all thanks to these people right here. Brandon Kennedy, we got Amanda Miller, we got Ben Kisco, we got Drew Woodburn, we have James Palmer, Katie Gates, we have Ruth Gebhardt, Brian Winnington, we have Adam, what's going on? That is it. Oh, yeah. Okay. The assault tier is that small, huh? It's just Brian Winnington hanging out. The fireman.
That's it.
And Jake, we have the Calvary tier. Read them off.
Okay. Calvary tier, Adam Holmes, who is getting married in October. We're going to do a little camping for his bachelor party. I know you're excited.
Dude, so we talked about camping, and you send a nice little text out. His dad's already just... Boom, boom, boom. Group text? Hell yeah, I'm in. And to me, I literally was like, oh my God, another group text. It's been fine. No one's been saying anything.
Dude, it's just us and two of his friends, and they are ghosting me hardcore. I'm pretty sure they're not going to come. I mean...
Adam's going to hear that. Tell Adam to get on.
Adam knows his friends are like...
Blakey?
He whittled it down to two out of... like a few people that he was friends with, you know, in college and
stuff.
Well,
fuck them. We're gonna get like obliterated.
All right, so you're
out
in?
There.
For real?
Yeah, I'm going.
Oh, sweet.
I'm good to go.
Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
What was I gonna say?
I'm reading still,
right? No.
You got it?
About Adam. About the group text.
Yeah.
And then once you did that, I think Matt replied, but I don't have Matt's number. I should. Come on. But I saw a text from a certain number that said, I'll be there. I'll be in my van. And then, like, I finally responded, like, I'll be there. I'll be in his van.
Yeah.
And then, like, all I did was, like, this party emoji.
It was so weird.
And I was like, that is not a Matt Miller reply. I texted Jake on the side. I'm like,
that's way weird like, on group text.
That was Matt, right?
He's weird on group text. He has, like, really? A different persona on, like, group text. Yeah, like, party Matt.
I'm him. I'm cool.
That app was, or that meme he sent was like,
what? That was out of control,
I didn't
dude.
Like it.
I literally had to like text somebody.
Yeah, I was like,
that's Matt, right? Because I said I was going to be in a van.
And for those that don't know, like, you could legitimately stay in that van.
I'm going to get a little thing for my truck.
It's a camper van. Are you?
Yeah, like a little something.
Dude,
some
I
want
to talk to you about that because it's three really sweet campsites that I can lock down this whole peninsula.
Yeah.
And then Matt Elias has a camper now, of course, right?
Okay.
He's got a big camper. But like, I want to get the three tent sites because that's the end of the peninsula.
It's and all yourself.
And then there's campground, like a camper site next to it that are kind of out of the way.
Yeah.
But I'm going to rent the campsites anyways because, I mean, I can sleep in
Elias's. The campsites are awesome.
I'm going to tent.
Where?
It's like Harper's Ferry. Oh, it's beautiful. I'll show you later.
Yeah. Anyways, back to it.
Chaptico Market and Deli.
Oh, which, that wonderful, wonderful chicken from Chaptico.
Wonderful Even chicken. Probably, owned by great people.
Yep. They own the chickens too. They're right out back. You can go pet them, little chicken farm.
I never go there because it's just not on my route, really.
It's never on mine either, and I feel I would love to go there more.
Yeah, I would too. But
we should make a trip.
There. They're doing good.
We gotta make a little. We should make a trip. You know why? Because I made a commercial for Lori. I did a little commercial thing for Lori.
Oh yeah, that'd be tight.
I'm gonna go there and just do a little fucking film.
Be real tight.
Talk about their stuff. I mean, they've supported us for a while now. So, anyways, go ahead.
Yeah. My brother Jackson Miller, Joe Lockman.
Joe Lockman, mayor of California.
Lindsay girl.
Lindsay's back.
That's her email, so that's why I said that. I've never seen that
Lindsay.
In my life.
No D.
Don't say it.
I'm not going to spell it.
It's a wild, you can never guess it. Lindsay
Actually,
girl, you can't spell it.
Nope.
I don't think so. Wild one.
That is Matt Norville. I mean, their names are right to the left.
I like reading people's email. There's a number you have to guess, and you have to guess who he's using as his server.
Matt
there.
Matt Norville is an OG. He came in as quickly as he could, as you could see, and he came out to that show we'll talk about.
I do want to talk about that show.
Yeah, and then lastly, we have Wes Rice.
Yes,
a great supporter, a good friend, and
we have Lori. We
just about to get to
okay,
that.
Okay, good
job, Jake. Because
I got you, dog.
Lori Birch and the Crescent Moon down at Soft Market in Leonardtown. One of the coolest spots you can go to has a beer garden out back. It has tons of stuff inside, like gardens and whatnot. And if you go up the stairs, gardens, plants. I mean. It has plants, it has pottery, it has candles, a garden.
Candles are gone.
Yeah. I said beer garden, it threw me off, I'm sorry.
I mean, maybe it does have garden.
We don't do ad reads, really. You know, we just ramble.
I mean, we'd love to do an ad read.
Oh, would love to. If you want to get on here and want us to talk about you a little bit, big dogs, we will do it. And but if you do go to Soft Market and you go up to upstairs, you will find Lori's the Crescent Moon up there with the coolest stuff in there. I gotta say, seriously,
it's cool. Yep.
Yep. We should get a store in there.
Zero store.
Yep. And then we pod from there. You know, just to go a little further than usual.
Yeah, that'd be more fun, probably. Yeah. Bring some more cops into the equation.
So freaking awful.
On the way home. Yeah.
Don't get wasted or anything, do we?
No, but it's never
fun. We used
to.
We got a little wild back. Yeah, we got three-hour shows
drinking, like, liquor. Starting...
We were wild boys.
Yeah, dude, it was...
Brent was out of control.
It was a little wild. It was a little wild.
Ugh. Anyways.
I mean, I enjoy that, but...
I do, too, but,
it's not worth the risk.
It does change everything when you're that just buzzed up and just yapping.
People used to listen to those three-hour shows.
They liked them. Some people did. Some people said it was just too long.
Well, I mean, take a break.
No kidding! Come back tomorrow.
Does anyone listen to Joe Rogan straight through?
No.
No way.
That's what I'm saying.
Do you listen to Audible book straight through? No. I mean, it's the same.
No shot, but I just finished the butt one, the book about butts.
Yeah.
It took me a while.
Took you a while, yeah.
Well, because I just went back to it today.
Was
out
it
of nowhere.
Good or no?
The end got so, like, white people steal this, so they steal that. Like, they were literally talking about Miley Cyrus and not giving credit to black women for twerking.
Do you really want credit for that? That's not a good thing.
No, there is a cool little, there's a cool SPAC story to it. There's a tribal kind of dance to it and whatnot, but it wasn't, it's not the twerking you're thinking of.
Do you really want
It's not the twerking you're thinking of.
It's some sort of gyrations or whatever.
Yes, of the central region, brother.
Okay, I was listening to Rogan, since we're on the topic, and then Peter Attia, whatever his name is, just some genius that he had on, and you know, about longevity and stuff. Yeah. He's Egyptian, right? And, like, the dude is squared away in all aspects of everything. He's super smart. During his little thing, he's like, well, you know, I was an immigrant, and it was very tough being the only non-white kid in the school. And I'm thinking, bro, would you rather been... one of many Egyptians in some crappy Egyptian town? Like, it's worse. It's the best case scenario for you.
And you stick out.
There's no one more giving than a group of white people. No offense, but, like, it's a good place to be in a white classroom.
I kind of have...
It's the best classroom on earth.
My sympathy for that kind of thing, like, is getting...
It gets so old.
It gets
like,
old,
dude,
because I
everybody.
We took Felix to, like, a school, like a pre...
Mike, you could do it.
No, no.
You're non-white, pretty much. You know what I mean? Like, you could do it.
I got called Mexican all the time.
Yeah.
Nothing against Mexicans, but when you're not that,
be the next David Goggins.
When you're not that nationality, and people are just throwing out nationalities out there,
does it really hurt you? It's just like you're stupid, and like everyone's stupid, and you call me stuff too, and it's just annoying. Would you rather be poor and broke in Egypt, or would you rather have a chance here
and maybe take a little shit for being a little?
And he didn't even say he did.
No, you know, the money returns or something.
He just said it was tough because no one looked like me. It's like, bro,
that sounds pretty awesome.
It is.
But that's what I'm saying, Jake. That's why I don't have really a lot of sympathy, because I'm like, Felix is missing an arm, and he shows up, and the entire playground stops.
No one looks like Felix.
Exactly.
That's legit.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it's not just.
It sticks out. It's weird. It's like it's unusual. Like, what are you talking about? Get over it. Just like he's going to get over it, and just like I'm going to tell him every day.
Dude, everybody takes
gently,
some sort of
I won't
bullet.
Just say get over it.
Everybody deals with
something.
Some people have it way less, of course. You know, if you're really good at things and you look good or whatever, you got a little bit less,
I used to tell you about that. I used to tell you all the time. I told you one time, like when I was younger, I would go into, like whenever I went to a new school or church or whatever, if there was a group of kids in a corner laughing, I would assume it was about me.
That's rough.
I'd always be staring, and I'd be like, are they talking about me? I'd be doing that Micah thing. Remember where you always catch his eye?
Yeah,
there's this one kid
eye.
You could not stare at longer than 10 seconds, and he would turn and look right at you. It was crazy.
Well, he was part Indian. I think he had it like sort of.
I knew you were going to say something.
That's so true. It's true.
That little thing starts going off like Jumanji. And
can I tell you a quick side story?
Someone's staring.
Quick side story. The other day we're in a big meeting at my work. Yeah. And the owner of my company is Native American, right? We're Native American owned. And one of the dudes was like, yeah, we're all sitting around Indian style. And he literally said, what kind of Indian style was that? It was so funny. He said, what particular...
Was there like a wagon in the middle?
It was so funny. And the guy was like, oh, crisscross applesauce, you know. He was joking, but it was funny. It was like, he caught him out.
Of course, that guy should know. No one means anything by it.
Of course, he does. And it was just funny to hear him joke, because he's a real dry humor guy. Yeah. He was like...
Like he's super Indian?
I mean, you grew up on a reservation in Maine.
Super Native American, I should say.
Grew up on a reservation in Maine.
Because it is, there is a difference. Native American, Indian. There, we should clarify. Like, they are definitely different.
What do you mean by, like,
the, Indian,
like India, Indian?
Yeah, those are different.
Yeah. I mean, it's
definitely not as cool, right?
Like, it could have been the West Indies is what he was going for.
Are Indians as cool as Native Americans?
No.
Not at all, right? not at all. Like, not even close. They don't have horses. They have elephants.
I mean, they still got
elephants are pretty dope, but, I mean, you can't have as many running
Indians
around.
Could cause them, like, you know, Indians, they could cause a major problem if they really wanted to, I think.
They could. They
could. They could. They could do some, like, some
they got that right hand
on.
They got that right hand. You know, if you know what that means,
I do. They're a crazy bunch.
Yeah.
But anyway.
And there's so many
funny.
Of them. Have you seen World War Z?
So many.
That's kind of what it would be like. They would all be piling on each other just to get over like super tall walls. To get into your city. You're not stopping them. There's
Dude,
so many.
They keep making more of them too. Like just nonstop.
Why do you think Native Americans did the old like... I don't know if they actually. I don't know if they actually did this.
Oh, yeah. Like that.
Like what is that?
I mean, it makes a pretty sweet sound.
It is a cool sound, but like what? It sounds like the White Lotus.
Like,
but
it's a war cry. Like let's go.
Like where did that come from? Like where did the Native American war cry come from? They actually did it with like their tongue though. They didn't do like the mouth over the.
Yeah.
But India, the people from India do that too.
They do like
something like that.
They have. Like, they walk like this. Their head bobbles all the time.
It's not what
I think it was already good.
That sounds terrifying. But, like, that guy, you're like, whoa. Pow Wow Songs recorded live at Pullman. Stay red. Oh, they can say red?
I know, man. It's crazy.
They can say red?
They were a skin color.
Is that bad to say, though? And why does that look like bacon? Stay red.
I don't know. It does, though. They, like, laid out bacon chips.
Hey, Red, eat your breakfast.
Can you look up the Indian head bobble explained?
Oh, you know why?
So funny.
Oh, a head... A what?
The Indian head... You know how Indian people, they, like... They go like
the headdress?
Like the real ones. No, real Indians.
No, not Native American men. Indians.
Like, all the men, they shake their head real funny like this all the time.
Yeah.
All the time. There's a lot of Indians in Singapore, and I mean, you know.
Indian head bobble.
Explain.
Oh, there it is. That's exactly it.
See what? Oh, I mean.
Head bobble.
No, you gotta watch a video of it. It's like I don't know, one of these, any of these guys.
There's a videos thing up top.
Yeah.
It's like the first thing up there. Top left. Yep.
I don't know which one's funny, but that chick's not gonna be funny.
Second video.
Yeah.
Are Indians aware of
the
head bobble?
It's safe from Asian boss. In India, there's a common gesture that many people do that can be very confusing to foreigners who aren't very familiar with Indian culture.
Oh my gosh.
Yes,
yeah,
we're
this
talking
guy.
About the famous Indian
Fast
head
forward
bobble.
A little bit. I just want to see
no,
a little.
He's explaining it.
I think that's it. But I can assure you it's one of the things that you did.
Voice right.
I do like that voice a lot.
I love that.
Can you guess? Oh, you know it.
I want to see the guys.
The girls don't really
turn up
do
the
it.
Computer fader.
There was this movie called...
Well, you gotta go to a comedian or like a guy that's doing it. Like that one right there. Check that one.
Coming to India as a foreigner, you'll notice people moving their heads.
And these people
down,
are like so nice.
Side to side. And
there's funny ones that they make fun of it. It's so funny.
The farther south you travel down the country, the what? More prevalent the head wobble
Dude,
becomes.
It's so ridiculous.
I still don't know why they're doing it.
As far south as
either.
You can go, and heads are bobbling everywhere.
Whoa. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Look at
that. Thank you very much. Is it a yes
dude,
or
they're
no?
Everywhere.
A nod of approval
don't
or
like
a
it,
false
dude.
Head shake. The answer can be
I
all of the above.
I still haven't seen a good one.
And it's so unique.
I'm telling
that it
you.
I mean,
own
that's,
video
not, that's like a dude reacting.
The yes wobble. The no wobble. The maybe wobble. The what's up wobble. The
no,
I understand
these are
wobble.
Weak.
And the wobble to acknowledge.
That one's a good one.
The most interesting thing that I find about head
that
wobbles
one.
Is that it's 100%
we need to find, like, a
everyone needs to look
one.
Up Indian
if
head wobble.
To do it on the spot,
if you listen
to
audio.
Can't.
It's pretty fun.
Everybody do the
I like it.
Yes.
Is it really up and down?
Yes.
See, that guy in the middle, he couldn't help it. He did a sideways one.
I'll be
Something
honest,
I've
though. You could stop
the
it now. But
the head wobble, the
that's
more
the
understanding
one. Most people just walk around
is.
Like this. Their head's just shaking, and it's so funny. But that one was too nice.
I'll be honest, though. I have a hard time, like, trusting, like, Indians because they're always, like, hackers. They're always the ones calling. They have, like, massive buildings full of them just trying to hack American, like, old Americans and steal their money. It's true.
I know.
They have massive buildings set I know, up just I've seen it. Trick old people in America into like sending them money.
They're brutal.
They don't give a shit.
And I don't know why.
Dude, and if you fuck with them for a long time, stop fucking with me. They start like yelling shit. They get pissed. Dude, they start being real mean.
I gotta find this other video. Dude, they're
they get mad.
I feel like those are the worst ones though.
That's as bad as they can be, though. Bad Americans too. It's But like I don't know if we have buildings full of people that are literally trying to hack.
I feel like their worst people are hackers. Like our worst people are like, you know, like serial murderers or
dark
whatever.
Web. Like.
Yeah, like their people are just they're just like hackers. That's the worst they got.
Yeah. That's true.
And I saw a comedian the other day.
You know what? That's a good point. It's just hacking. But I really, 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 really dislike hackers, dude.
Fluffy, he might be able to make a good one, but probably not. Yeah, hackers are so bad.
I really hate them, dude. They're so sleazy. Yeah, they're fucking assholes, dude. I had somebody just hacking, like, I can take and buying games on my PlayStation. And, like,
that's terrible.
There was nothing I could do. And I'm like trying, like, PlayStation has the worst customer service you could imagine, Jake. $1 billion company.
You said?
PlayStation. Sony. Well, you can't even get a hold of anybody because everything's like outsourced and they just wait. I don't even know what happens actually. They just outsource you to the people that hacked you.
I want y'all to watch this video if you don't mind.
Well, you gotta email it or
you can Google it. Is it too bad to watch a comedian on it? Its name is Joe Koy, J-O-K-O-Y, Asian.
50-50 chance there.
Asian accents. It's how to tell Asians apart. So I don't know if that's the right one. Dude, it's funny. I mean, I laugh.
I actually have heard. This recently.
You seen it already?
Just because like one sounds like you're smoking.
Forget the accents. It's Joe Koy, how to tell Asians apart. Yeah, well.
Yeah, right there. How to tell Asians
that's
apart.
Probably it. Dude, it's pretty funny. And this guy is barely Asian. You know what I mean? Like.
And we look. I look out into the crowd. You can't tell us apart. You can. You know how many Mexicans my mom walks up to and goes, Filipino?
Oh, my gosh.
Mexican! Sorry. There's a way you can tell Asians apart from other Asians.
This is pretty funny.
It's by their accent, and only if they have accents. Out of all the Asians, Koreans are the easiest. Because when a Korean person talks, they sound like they've been smoking weed all day. Like right before they talk, just.
That's ridiculous. Is that what they sound like?
That's so dead on, dude. He nailed it.
Koreans sound like Asian ghosts.
He nails all of them. That's why it's so funny.
My best friend growing up was Korean. I remember the first time I went to his house, his dad yelled from upstairs. I thought the fucking house was haunted. Swear to God, right when I walked in. I was like, what the fuck was that? He said, oh, it's my dad. He just wants to know if you're hungry.
Dude,
you do that with any
That's
Asian.
What I enjoy about this.
Vietnamese.
I just press spacebar.
I haven't even done anything yet.
That's what I. Felix, like the school he wants to go to, they teach them like everything about around the globe, like the entire time. All the
what school?
Star Maker.
Yeah, it's called Star Maker.
Yeah, I know.
Which I love, even though I'm pretty sure
it's Montessori school. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Special Italian learning style.
I can't imagine like going to like some Asian kid's house when we were young. I barely went to any other nationality's house when you were young, but I grew up on base.
Dude, I was.
And I went around the country on bases. And so, like, you would have, unbelievable amount of men were married to, like, Thai people.
Yeah.
And Asians.
Of course.
All the time. That's where I first heard of lumpia.
Yeah.
I love lumpia, dude.
It's Filipino.
Yep. And it's wonderful. But why were they? There's so many of them married to Thai Asians. Because they were stationed over there, right?
Yes.
And they just.
You bring them back. Dude, these girls are, like, very loving.
They're, like, just love
very
me.
Very nice.
And they're, like, just take me to America. I love you.
Yeah, but they're good women, too, though.
No, absolutely. They all were.
And, like, they they're really good to men. Really good.
It's like a
hoity-toity white chick from like the suburbs.
Versus
they're tough to handle sometimes. Yeah. If you can get like a poor Filipino.
Dude,
like,
I remember one time I stayed at. Jeez. You're the knight. You're the hero of the story.
You're the hero. You're rich.
You're like worshipped and loved.
Yes, you're loved and worshipped until you're not, which is a bunch of times that's what happens.
That happens.
They
really show you how they really feel. But I honestly believe that's if you are kind of like a dick yourself.
I think so too.
But that can happen when you have someone kind of serving
you
hand and foot.
You're 20 years old.
Yep.
You joined the military.
I'm thinking.
You just got out of high school.
Uh-huh.
And you're now on a ship and you're like, you know, you're stationed in Subic Bay, Philippines for like a year. And you're just having a great time. You fall in love with the culture. They're treating you very well. All the women are like, they're fawning over Americans. In the Philippines, they love American. They do. Yeah. And they're kind of like, they're American in a way as far as they were settled by the Spanish. So like they're Catholic. So they understand like, you know, Christianity a little bit. It's some weird version of Catholicism. It's not like what
not
we would
weird.
Call.
That's spread out everywhere. That's another story though.
But as far as Asia goes, the rest of them are not. They're like Buddhist or Hindu or whatever.
Yeah.
Very far. It's very, they're like, the cultures don't meet there. But the Philippines were settled by the Spanish, like settled. They were already settled, but they were colonized by the Spanish who spread
Catholicism.
That's
another weird thing, dude.
It is.
Colonizing someone that's already kind of like established. You're like, no, 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 no. But hold on. I know you guys think you got something, but this is the real
dude,
thing.
Dude, they loved it. They loved the priest showing up and like, giving
them church.
Of course,
you watch these people come in and like they have like unlimited money and like. They have this crazy like attire on and stuff that's worth like so much. And they're like, this is how I got it. Boom.
Yeah.
And you're like, I want that. Yep.
Yep.
Yep. Have you guys ever thought about like living forever after
yeah,
death?
Yeah. Like, you know.
And they're like, really?
Are you into that?
Are you kind of into that?
Do you guys have like any like alms you want to give us?
What happens when you die?
Yeah.
I know what happens when I die.
So anyways, you're 20.
Wait, hold on.
And like,
what does happen with the Philippines? Like what was their original? Was it Buddhism or?
Savages, bro.
What was their thing, dude?
Nothing. They probably had some. They were. Let's put it this way: they were anxious for something that had a little more structure than whatever they
finally.
Had. They're like, dude, we don't know what happened to the last millennium, but
bunch
we're
of white
ready.
Dudes came
yeah.
from like you know the north.
What are you gonna type in? Filipino
Philippine original like yeah.
original religion.
Original religion.
Prior to Spain. So
yeah,
you're
prior
20.
To Spain.
You're like you know you're maybe don't have any prospects back home. Like the high school girls didn't love you too much, and now you're over there. You got this girl that loves you, marry her.
Yeah,
you know, bring her home.
I mean, it's like an easy choice.
I do want to watch the rest of that joke, Koi.
The nature of religion in the pre-colonial Philippines is often unclear. Religions include animism, indigenous religious beliefs and mythologies such as Anito, and influences from Hinduism and Buddhism. The earliest pieces of evidence that exist are archaeological finds, including Hindu-Buddhist gold statues, which they could have just been coming down just like the, you know, the Spanish.
Dude,
the Spain
they
was.
Were, they didn't know what was going on.
They're all
they
over the place. Kind of like
they
America,
did
dude.
Not have an established religion.
America's all over the place right now, too.
We have an established religion.
Somewhat.
Like you, like
obviously,
you,
Christianity.
You can join a religion if you want. You know,
right, right,
there.
Right.
But, yeah.
I'm thinking about I got to hit. I'm trying to get Felix back into a... Or back in Felix into a church, but we were waiting till he was like potty trained to kind of go back and do that. But
it's important.
Hey, if he pees or poops, come get me.
Yeah,
it should be that freaking easy, right?
It's important.
I think so too. Absolutely. That's right. I mean,
it provides a bunch of things. Structure for
yes,
one. It provides something to believe in.
Foundation.
Which is hope. You know, your kid should know about that stuff.
And he can. Yeah. But then again, wait, what are you doing?
I want to watch the rest of that joke, boy, real quick.
Okay.
You gotta see the rest of it. Then we can move on. We're talking about kids in church. All right, we're on the Vietnamese.
Vietnamese, I love Vietnamese people. You're my, I love you. You're the smallest of the Asians.
Is that true?
Probably.
He You're said smaller, it. But I will tell you this: don't fuck with Vietnamese people. They will fight anybody. Those little fuckers will fight any. They don't give a shit. I don't care how strong you are. They will fight you. They will run up to you and say shit.
I didn't hear this part. I just want to hear the voices part, but I guess
That's
he gets to
feet.
It. The one I saw was like edited.
I had one run up to me at the end of the show. hey, dude, what you say to me like that, dude?
Dude, look how diverse
they talk
his crowd
real fast. Yeah. You know they talk that fast. They talk like that, real fat like dude. What you say to me like that, dude?
Oh my God.
They talk real fat like that, dude.
I like that accent.
Yeah.
Koreans sound like they've been smoking weed all day. Vietnamese people sound like they've been doing cocaine their whole life. Hey, dude, what you say to me like that, dude? Don't you talk to me like that, dude?
That's
what
his
you
main
say
sentence.
To me like that?
I would never put my name behind anything, but
why not? Just,
I don't know,
people go high, they go real high like that, dude. They go down low like that, they start low like that, dude. They go real high like that, dude.
Anyways, I wanted to talk about Vietnamese since he brought him up, because I don't know nothing,
dude.
That's a weird country. I mean, obviously we had a long ass war there.
I went there.
Yeah.
And I think the best of all the Asian food. It was the freshest. It's the hardest to get around here, it seems like. And I've never had it since, but man, I'm telling you, it was so good. I felt
good.
What
do you mean? It's like hot.
Like, when you eat there, when you walk out of a restaurant, or when you walk out, you feel better. You know how you like eat a sub
here?
What's
that about?
You feel like down in the dumps.
Yeah, absolutely.
You feel better there. It's just like fresh and like, they don't eat a lot of like, it was good.
Preservatives. It's like fresh food.
It was awesome. Yeah. I don't know, man. It was just like lettuce wraps
and stuff. Spicy food and stuff?
Not too bad, not like Thailand or whatever, but
is there?
And I was in South.
You said there wasn't a lot of Vietnamese restaurants around here. I'm trying to think. It would be DC probably, right? Dude,
yeah.
I kind of want to go like some new places like this and try them out.
So I
dude.
Remember my dad was working in Springfield, Virginia. There was like an enclave of Vietnamese people that worked with him, and like they had some spots, obviously. But they were like, he's like, dude, these guys, they show up and they're like the hardest workers ever, and they were like fresh immigrants from like the war, you know, like Vietnamese
dude,
war.
The stuff he had them doing. Was probably nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like, in comparison, they probably crushed it.
Yeah.
He's right. That's what I'm saying. Like, it was probably just
working
like
on a printing press, you know, like making newspapers, and it's hard work.
Oh,
like,
shoot. I forgot that's
that
what he was
stuff.
Doing.
Yeah,
that's different.
But, yeah, like, there is Vietnamese restaurants. I'm telling you, they're not the same. Like, they all have the pho.
Come on,
you know,
let's see you spell Vietnamese. Oh.
Jerry did. Everyone's heard of pho, right? P-H-O.
Yeah. Oh, pho. Oh, yeah.
It's just like ramen, but, yep. Like, they have more stuff than that.
Saigon. Wait, what's that pho delight? That's near us, right?
It's Saigon.
That's Waldorf.
So I went to Saigon. Man,
we should definitely start trying some of these places out.
We should. I'm down with that.
Yeah,
I would love to go.
Want
to
do date nights
food.
And stuff? Let's go. We'll go find new places to eat.
I want
to
eat
cool places.
Like, yeah, Vietnamese food. Okay, so I was in southern Vietnam, which is like they were the friends of, you know, America. We were fighting with them against the North Vietnamese Army, right? Mm-hmm. It was North Vietnam versus South Vietnam, basically. And
yeah.
We were defending South Vietnam. Well,
why are we always defending the South?
We left, and they basically took over. And it is a socialist country now, mm-hmm. You know, like the North one. So, like, Hanoi, which is the capital
yes.
there up north, is a little more... I didn't go there, but I know people that have, and it's very more like that people are a little less friendly towards America. In the South, dude, they're awesome. They're just the friendliest people ever.
I was
enamored with Vietnamese people and Vietnam in general. It's beautiful. Of course, they have like, you know, telephone poles with like 8 billion wires on them and stuff like that. But they have beautiful beaches. They have.
Why is there such a difference between like northern and southern people? Like even in our country, everywhere, like not even politically or anything, like just people. I would say like a lot of people I see in the South are pretty unhealthy, but they're all super like fun. They're super like,
dude, you're right. Like North Korea,
super sweet,
South Korea,
they're super like party animals, but they're like conservative, but they're, you know, and then the North is kind of uptight. They're
yeah.
funnish. They have their nights, but
more
like
busy and more
busy, more fast.
More like brash and like, and kind of like, not so polite.
More like,
not
I guess.
Bad.
Yeah, I don't
pull
know.
Pull
There's
up that map with that. The map.
Well, hold on. Let's look at this.
Let's see where it is.
This is Vietnam?
Dude, Vietnam has some of the most beautiful beaches you've ever seen in your whole life.
Yeah, but imagine. But hold on.
Look at that coastline.
Yeah, but imagine like you're going there to like fucking war. Like people see this much differently. You know, certain people.
So our people hung out in Da Nang, which was where like, that was where all, if you ever talked to a Marine ever that was in Vietnam, they'll tell you about Da Nang. That was like, you know, where a big base was. And they all hung out because it was like,
it looks
away from the fighting. Yeah, it is beautiful. So I was in Ho Chi Minh, which is AKA Saigon.
Oh, there we go. There's a good map.
See Ho Chi Minh City? That's where I was.
Give us a second. Yeah, I see it. Yeah.
Bottom right.
It's right above your finger, man. Right above that finger.
That used to be called Saigon.
Yeah.
Ho Chi Minh was the guy that was running the show back then, so they renamed it Ho Chi Minh City.
There is this. I had a Zero idea a long time ago, and I'd never finished it.
See, Na Trang was a big one. There's so many. Na Trang, right? But right, three words below.
Yeah,
right
there. I see it.
There were some big battles in that area.
So there was a woman from this area. I'm not sure if it was China or it was Vietnam or somewhere. I'm looking at this map. But I was reading about her, and I thought it would be a good Zero idea, and I haven't finished it yet, so I'm not going to go long on it. But she literally took on, like, everyone's naval. Like, they had to bring in, like, the British Navy to come in because she was a pirate that basically was just
like
obliterating.
Way back.
Oh, way back. And I'm still finishing. Nah, don't even look it up. I don't even want to look it up because I do want to finish it. This made me, like, it kind of like, she was a whore. A prostitute that, like, worked on a ship that used to go around the coast, and they would just bang. They would stop at cities, and they would get people to pay, blah, blah, blah. This one pirate was an actual pirate. They used to go fight, like, he would actually, like, he had deals with the government and would go fight, like, in Vietnam. That's why Vietnam made me think of it. But he would come back, and, like, he fell in love with her. Just her. And he actually burned that ship to the ground just so she had nowhere to work and came with him. And eventually, like, he went off and he died and she took over. And there's actually, I think there's a Netflix movie about it, but I was kind of like trying to go as far in depth as I could through like Wikipedia and stuff like that. But she like took over this whole, all these pirates and like was just pillaging, taking over everything. And she actually saved a lot of like the captured like women from getting raped and stuff. She actually stopped all that. And eventually she just wiped out all of their naval stuff, and they had to call, I guess it was UK. They came in with their naval. They couldn't beat her. And then eventually they made a deal with her. And she settled down. And that's, yeah, you pulled it up.
Well, you told the whole story.
I know. But that's her. Yeah, I know I did. But I'm not sure about the all. Yep, Zhang. Yeah. Zhang Yi
Sao.
That's
like a Chinese sounding name.
It is China.
Indochina.
She's Chinese.
Yeah.
But the guy used to go fight in Vietnam all the time or around there because they're that trade route. That they wanted. It's a whole story. That's why I never finished
that
it.
Same trade route is still in dispute today. Like,
I'm saying.
It's
so
relevant.
It's such a deep, long story that I never really finished it. I'll let you read it because I want to just kind of like do more deep dives like that sometimes. And you know, it goes. We run out of time.
I have a semi deep dive for you. Can you go back to the map? A map of that area. Like, so when we left Vietnam,
show that picture of her real quick. There seems
pretty wild.
Just her name is Zhang. It's that second one down above the Google. Yeah, you won't see those. I think some of those are just pictures.
Those are horrors, roughly. So when America and the rest of the world pulled out of Vietnam, which, by the way, Vietnamese had just fought the French. You know, the French colonized Vietnam.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of French culture in Vietnam, which is awesome. Like coffee culture and stuff, sitting outside in cafes and all that French stuff exists in Vietnam. It's wild. They had just fought them in like the 50s. And then next thing you know, America's there. And everyone else, and we're trying to fight the North.
Hey!
So Cambodia. See Cambodia there?
Oh, no. Hold on.
Cambodia, when America and everyone else, the West, you know, kind of left Vietnam. Like, we left, right? We kind of, tails between our legs, did not really do anything, left. Cambodia was still under the leadership of the Khmer Rouge. Want to learn how to spell that? It's Khmer Rouge. The worst dude ever. He wanted to go back to an agrarian society, so he basically killed anyone that was a doctor or a scientist or a lawyer or whatever. It happened in Cambodia.
Don't people
look
follow.
Up? Can you Google the killing fields?
Oh, I just read about this.
Did you, dude? It happened and nobody cared.
There's a pile of skulls.
I went there.
Ugh.
I went there, and the dude that drove me there.
They talk about it like
he
now,
told
like,
me his parents were there, and I was like, "Bro, I'm sorry, I didn't know that."
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like he was a. It's not old. The rest of the world turned their head, blind eye, to like the
absolute
whores.
Well, there was no real purpose, right, to go there maybe, or we didn't
well,
have...
Well, dude, I mean...
It wasn't on the coast.
Out of all the places in the world we could have done...
Yeah, that like, was something.
Dude, it's just like... You remember...
That doesn't seem much different than
like Sudan or something, you know? Like,
or that doesn't seem much different than the Nazis.
These are... Yeah.
Same thing.
Worse. These are atrocities that were happening. The Khmer
Rouge.
Why
were the Khmer Rouge so brutal? The killing fields. Oh, sorry, Amanda. All right. Number of sites in Cambodia where collectively more than 1 million people were killed and buried by the Khmer as I say it, Khmer Rogue regime, which is the Communist Party of Kampuche, during its rule of the country from 1975 to 1979. That is it. 1975 to 1979.
Killed a million.
4 years.
A million people.
I mean, think of
the world doesn't even know. There is a movie about the Killing Fields because somebody was like, "Let's show."
Which good thing for the thankful.
But generally speaking, this happened basically right as we were leaving. Dude, see that tree? Been there. It's sick. That's where they used to kill the babies. They would slam them against the tree. I have seen that, and it is very sad.
Yep, that's the tree they smacked babies against.
And downtown Phnom Penh.
Who the heck could do that?
They slammed their head against that tree, and then they chucked the babies away.
I guess it just got easier with time, maybe, but I don't know how you could do that. But what does it say against? Like, it says killing tree against which executioners beat children. Oh, that's it.
Dude, it's a sad.
What's put on there? Like little just bracelets?
Yeah. That country is in deep doo-doo still because they killed all the smart people. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They are struggling, and it's like, I rode through a space there that was the stinkiest place I've ever been on Earth, and you could barely breathe in it. It was honestly breathtaking.
What was it?
It was sewage. Yeah.
So Jake.
But it was
so bad. So I mean, that is literally how you send a country into the dark ages.
Yes.
And so I mean, don't you see that's kind of like the China's easy way of doing that to us with this TikTok bullshit and how. You know what I'm saying? Like how they don't have the dumb shit on their servers. You know what I'm saying? Like what their kids watch, what their people watch. That's one part, I guess, one aspect. But then it's just, I think it's fake numbers. I think it makes everyone feel kind of important on TikTok because you feed them fake numbers. You feed them fake likes, feed them fake bots, everything, right? Make them feel loved. That would make them come over. And then they just get bombarded with bullshit, dumb shit, and there's really nothing to be learned on there. I mean, there is some sites.
I honestly don't.
There's some
don't
profiles
do TikTok,
that try to teach things, but.
So here's my thing.
I
agree with everything you just said, except I think people underestimate that the Chinese people are also, they're on the internet too. It's not like, they're not as closed. They are a closed society, but they're not nearly as closed. Like they know what's out there, and like, they're just like us. They're just like our kids. They're addicted to looking at their phone too. You know what I mean? It's not like they're all
Everybody
in it together.
Yeah, don't watch that.
They're not all in it together. Like they're not looking at their phone at 8 o'clock at night, and they're like going to take over and march towards America.
I think they actually do have time.
They got
limits.
Their own problems with their own citizens. Dude.
I think they do have time limits actually.
I think they do, but I think they're mad
Can you look
about
up
it.
China
no,
has
I think they're
time
mad.
Limits on their phones.
I think the citizens are not down with that. Like the government.
They should be.
They have a government that's the same as our dumb government run by idiots.
Oh, they have time limit on gaming, everything.
Yeah, their citizens want freedom, dude. They do.
Yeah, 3 hours weekly of online gaming time.
They don't want that.
So I think that's a great. I mean, it's hard to say like that. It says like many other parents. Oh, never mind. This is a Lee is happy with the new government restrictions that limit children to just 3 hours weekly of online gaming time, an hour between 8 and 9 p.m. on Friday, Saturday and Sunday most weeks.
Dude,
that's it.
How do they regulate that?
With they cut it off.
They can look in your house, basically. They have, like,
I would imagine they can just cut it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That's why it says not 8 to 9.
You have to log on. Dude, that's terrible.
It's pretty bad.
If you want to make a perfect society that has perfect little robots, like, that's the way to do it.
But, bro, they're seeing the world like this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, they're seeing the world of, like, we need to be on top.
China's not doing it right. Isn't that annoying, though?
Shouldn't we just figure out a way to just kind of live and, like, not constantly be in squabbles and see who's on top, but they're all just constantly fighting it's all above us, and then we're the one that
Chinese people are just like the majority of Americans. Like, we don't want the government in our lives. They don't either.
That's the majority of like every citizen ever.
I know these governments are evil. I don't know why.
It's always government. It's always money. It's just always dumb shit.
Power. It's weird. I don't understand it.
It's literally no one else.
The reason I don't understand and the reason no one can explain it is because I do believe there is an evil force like. In charge of it. There has to be.
That runs.
It doesn't make any sense.
I don't know.
What is the nonstop?
It's just money, dude, and power.
It's not even money, though, some of these people. It's
true. I mean, they have so much. It's like, what could it
possibly? Well, some of them don't even have that much. They just want power. Like your local, like.
No, dude. Those people make money by insider trading and by letting things go through. And they make so much money on the side.
They're going to have a massive problem with their own citizen, China. They're not going to be able to, dude, their citizens do not want to go fight a war. They can't even look at their, you know, it's like getting the North Korean citizens to do something, dude. They're miserable too.
I don't really want to fight them. Why?
We did, of course. We fought them in the Korean War. We fought the Chinese, really. I mean, it was really the Chinese.
Most Russian people are kind of against the war, too.
Exactly, dude.
It's just like, what are we doing? Why do we continue to let them send us into this bullshit? Into death. Certain death.
I remember.
Which I believe is, at the end of the day, is population control, because I do believe that the governments believe that, you know, the world suffers the more people there are that are on it. I do. I think they have to slice off.
But they also want more, like, taxpayers. So I don't really know.
I think they slice off whenever they can. I really do.
You know,
Ever seen, just on top of that, have you ever seen What Jupiter Does For Us? So, Amanda, pull up Jupiter. What Jupiter Does For Us GIF.
Can you tell me why the moon doesn't spin?
Just the way it's in our gravitational pull perfectly,
I guess. Why is the sun not, like,
I mean, that's weird, but yeah.
It's so weird.
Often protects Earth from other inner planets by deflecting comets and asteroids. Sometimes it sends...
purpose, or is it just like, it just happens to be
Jake,
there?
No, Jake, not on purpose. It's just because of the pull of it, how big it is.
Yeah, it just happens to be there.
So there's a GIF, if you look in images. Images.
Easy.
It's just so hard to watch.
Gosh, what do you mean? What do you want me to do?
No, you got it.
No, you're fine. There. You did great. There should be a GIF. You can see like that. That's an artist, obviously, illustration, but there was an actual one where we have trackers. Oh, to the left in that row. All the way to the left in that row.
I see it.
All the way to the left in that row. Yep, that one right there. Click on that. There you go.
Cat.
There you go. Look at this image. Oh, boy, what just happened? I know that was...
I clicked on the image.
That was weird.
Yeah, it's
Click
internet.
New tab or whatever.
The internet being funky. Might have to visit.
Open link error. There is no open image.
Yeah, hit
image.
That one. It's going to take you to a website where you have to try to figure
it
out.
It's like a really good... And it's the same, like, all across the board. Like, they show you exactly... I mean, dude, there's some devastating asteroids in there. Comets that would just literally
wipe out. So that means we shouldn't try to live on Jupiter.
No, I think it gets hit. I think it attracts attracts all of that. It keeps it kind of in this weird... I mean, look at that. Isn't that wonderful what that looks like? Look at this.
I mean, God made it like the way I love it.
And I don't dispute that. I'm just saying, like, look what we're up against. It's not... It sucks, and we're complaining about, like, such a small, like,
all
a grain
right, where
of sand.
Are we at? What's going on here?
That's the sun.
Okay.
And then the earth, and then I know, you can't
Where's
see
Where's
the
earth? The green one?
I believe so.
And we got real close to Jupiter. I don't know
Bro,
about
we go
that.
Through an asteroid field every single year. We pass right through one, and it just kind of misses us, or we get lucky, or small ones hit us. And I mean, that's what shooting stars are. Like, it's small grains up to, you know, eventually we get hits. What do you say?
I think this one's Jupiter.
Yes.
Yeah.
So and it kind of keeps them in that. It's like a.
Like towards it.
Yeah. If you think like a if you think like a whirlpool, it would keep them in that little, that wave, and it perfectly keeps them away from that center, dude. It's crazy.
Yeah.
And then
Yeah.
Guys, I know it sounds ridiculous on audio. You would have to definitely look at what we're looking at, but dude, I do actually worry about that. I worry about that more than like
I don't
the climate. I know. Oh, if it hits.
I've literally never worried about an asteroid attack.
Really? Because it's wiped out like a lot of stuff
I just don't
over
know
and over
about
again.
That.
And volcanoes too. I worry about volcanoes. They're scary as hell, dude.
But you got that's why you don't have to believe that it's going to happen
again. I'm not sitting here like crippled by fear. Over like
good.
Over it. I'm saying it is
people
something
are, like Joe Rogan is like.
It
you
is
know,
something that I
so
think about.
Worried.
No, it's something I think about.
But we know it's not going to happen.
Look at history. Okay, hold on.
While we're here, you know what I mean.
Like,
That's what the Bible's for.
Well,
tells
that's
you.
What it does.
No. I was thinking of like.
So you know me.
A video.
How old do you think I think the Earth is?
Jake,
just go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead. Say Jake. It.
Don't do this.
No. You don't know my answer. I've explained it before, but I have a feeling you still think.
How old do I think you think it is?
Yeah.
I would hope.
No, and when I say the Earth, I mean the universe. Like you know everything.
Billions.
Actually, I don't know. I mean, but I'm not a young earther. You know, I'm not a 10th to 13,000. Although all of the evidence points to a massive extinction right around, you know, 13th when the earth appeared.
Bothersome.
I'm a gap theory guy.
Right.
Which is in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Boom, done. And then a bunch of weird stuff happened.
Yeah.
And then the earth was without form and void. And then he made the earth in its present state. About 12,000-13,000 years ago. I do believe that. But all the evidence, the earth was still here. The rocks and whatever was here. He had to reform it. from old stuff. So I like that. I believe space and all that. Dude, I have no idea how old it is. And honestly, nobody does, right?
No one does.
I believe it's a long,
What they do, Jake, is like with the ice and the snow, how it traps stuff, carbon and all that.
You can look up how old the Earth right now and you'll get
multiple. It's hard to
50 to 200 billion years old.
4.6 billion.
Oh, yeah, but if you look it up, it'll probably give you a billion years. 4.5. Yeah, but like no one agrees on that.
How old is the Earth?
Plus or minus 50 million years.
Who the hell? It says people also ask, and it says, how old is the Earth in human years?
Do you see how it says plus or minus 50 million years?
What are the years?
I'm sorry, but that's not.
Wait. Plus or minus what?
That is not good enough for me.
Jake.
Plus or minus 50?
In billions?
Million years? That's too big.
Take it in billions? 1,000 million is 1 billion?
If you read that, you should know that they have no idea what they're talking. Dude, 1 billion is what? 999?
1,000 million.
Yeah, 1,000 million.
Yes.
That's so 4.5 is really low. 4,000 millions.
Wait. Yes. 4, almost
5,000. What's 4,000 divided 4. By 50?
4,500,000, yeah. Now, if you do 50 million, that's 4,000, so small.
It's like 2% or something.
It's something low, yeah. Okay. Fair. Yeah, that's really low.
But 50 million... It's so big.
Jake, 50 million out of 1,000 million. Right? 5 times over.
So that's like telling...
That's really
small. What's 50 divided by 4,000? I'll do it.
What's 50 divided by 4,000?
Yeah, it'll tell you the point.
0.0125. That's real low.
Still stupid.
That's a pretty good goddamn guess, Jake. That's a good guess.
It's a guess. You're right about that.
Hey,
50
no doubt.
Million years.
Motherfucker, they're looking back in time.
Hey, you know what? It says plus
through
or
minus. You know,
double it because it says plus or minus. That's 100 million. You know what I mean? That's 100.
Right.
That's 100 million spread. That's,
that was a little tricky way of saying
like
that.
Two and a half to three, yeah, that's 2.5 to 3%. I mean, that's.
Hold
that,
on.
That's
so,
not a lot.
So, in the betting field in sports, like if it was plus or minus 0.01, whatever, you'd be like, God dang, that's a bet. I'll take that.
The house would win. They don't have a clue, dude. Why would they even put 0.54?
I don't know, dude. I really...
Just put 4 or 5 and be done with it.
I
nobody believes this crap anyway.
All bullshit aside, I really just look at that thing, and it is just so wondrous that we're fucking on that in a hippie moment right here. A really hippie moment.
Dude, we're there right
it's
now.
It's so freaking wonderful, and we still get thrown in fights, forced in fights. We were just so attracted to negativity.
It's because there's evil out there, dude.
We're spinning on this.
Evil's real.
That's been wiped. Man, we can look up comets that have. We can look at comets that have hit Earth. What are you?
You really want to go down this dark, deep rabbit hole?
What rabbit hole?
Comets that.
I just want to see. No. I there's actual footage of a large meteor. Large meteor. Just type in large meteor that's hit a video. I don't think comets.
It's not a video.
4.5 billion
years. It says 5 most dramatic asteroids caught on camera.
An asteroid, not a comet.
That's what I said. I changed it. Did I not? Or I said meteors. I'm sorry.
No,
same thing.
Comet.
It's on video. You guys can rewatch it later and argue about it.
This is so
fun.
Here we go.
Terror in the sky. Meteorites slamming into the earth. Over 1,000 people injured. The shockwave blowing
people
out
injured,
windows
dude.
And knocking
Look,
down walls.
That's just
all
one small rock.
Hours before our planet faces another close call.
Imagine
seems
seeing
fake,
something like that streaking across
Look,
the sky.
Yeah, all this.
Look at that thing.
The biggest meteor to hit the planet in a century.
Full screen.
It happened in Russia in the town of Chelyabinsk, about 900 miles east of Moscow.
It was wild.
The people there thought they were under attack.
I want to live in Chelyabinsk.
We have Team 7 coverage. Dave Rexroth
yeah, it's already
will
been
be
hit.
Along answering our questions about this strange
yeah, right?
event. But let's begin with
Look
Linda.
At that guy.
He's like the comet guy.
He didn't even get on the screen.
Imagine this. You
they
can
cut
see
back.
That's
stupid our screens are back there.
I mean, they're ridiculous. No one uses
five pictures.
Yeah, this is a bunch of buttons underneath
an
it.
And as a result,
this guy pressing buttons
meteorite.
Like he's working.
She's sitting in the control room, like, go get on the stage or whatever.
Seeking medical treatment right now. And
well, she's busy, bro.
Did anyone die?
When it happened.
1,000 people were injured.
Yeah.
But this is a small one, dude. Look.
Injured.
Came out of nowhere.
Look.
A blinding flash of
it's
light
the biggest shooting star you ever see.
The sky,
oh.
And then... The
shockwave of exploded
in the air.
The blast shattering windows throughout
the
city. The
atmosphere breaks it down.
Everybody got killed.
This zinc factory.
Look at that.
Witnesses but they said 1,000 people
under attack.
Got injured.
What?
Yeah, people thought they were under attack.
Of course, the they're in Chelly Banks, chaos. Russia, or whatever.
Look how bright this is. This is my computer or what?
Most by broken glass.
I know.
I can't see anything.
Say this was the biggest meteor in a century. Over 7,700 tons. Much of it burned
where
up
is
in
it at?
Most of it burns up in the atmosphere.
Fragments slammed into the ground.
Let me see that rock. Let me see that rock.
A tons of small rocks. They're right there. Jake, what do you think? This is fake now?
No, I'm not. I want to see the hole.
They're showing it.
I don't want to see this guy. I want to see the hole.
Look, Jake. Look, here you go.
Oh, gosh.
It's a recreation.
All right. I don't want to see the recreation.
What do you think? We just got cameras in space?
I want to see the hole.
Look, it breaks apart through the atmosphere. It's just a rock.
I know.
It doesn't have any kind of coating or...
I know. I want to see the hole.
But most of it falls harmlessly in unpopulated areas.
Let Disney get to it. Let Pixar get to it.
GFX, the National Safety Council, estimates you're nearly twice as likely to be struck by lightning than hit by an asteroid. Oh, see,
now they're faking us out here. Well, no, that was different. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what that scene was, dude.
You're more likely to get hit by lightning than asteroid. They're trying to, like, you know, not scare someone.
We got fireworks now, and look, they have a couple pictures of smaller pieces hit. You can see smaller pieces.
I get it. You know, some rocks are flying around.
It breaks apart.
Rocks are flying around out there.
But dude, all it takes is like there is no. There's an actual website you could type. Russia hole.
Yeah, tell you banks.
He wants to see the hole.
That's not it. They're showing all kinds of stuff. They're showing all.
See what I'm saying? Like, don't you want to see the hole?
Okay, man. A minute. Look.
All of a sudden, they can fit the rock in the back of that guy's truck.
Hold on. Well, some of them. Amanda. All right. Meteor. Meteor. Map. Simulator.
Asteroid.
Yep. No. Trust me. This is gonna be awesome.
I know.
Asteroid launcher. There you go. Yep, asteroid launcher. So this is what you could change. You could change the diameter, the speed, and then the impact angle.
Oh, sweet.
The impact angle.
What it would do?
Yes. So you could also change... Mechanicsville. Hold on. You could also change what kind of asteroid it is, which it's on iron right now. They could be gold, which would be great for U.S. Stone. Just stone. Carbon. Just a comet, which
is
different.
What's that made of? Yeah, like, come
cleaning
on.
Cleaning product, gold asteroid, an iron asteroid, and we're back to iron.
So is there really gold flying around? That seems...
Wild, right?
Yeah.
Jake, that seems fake.
I didn't say fake.
We're in a simulator, bro. Like, whoever's playing the game is catching gold comets and
Why
stuff.
Why is there...
So basically, let's zoom out. Go to where we live.
Do you think there's
Actually,
new...
Actually, go to DC.
Do you think there's new elements that we don't know about that are on another planet?
This is so fun, by the way. Yeah, absolutely. Bacteria, everything. What do you want to do? You want to do gold? That's going to be heavy and hard.
I want to hit Mechanicsville.
Now, let's do the diameter. We can go small. Go small. Go like 100. Just go to like 3 feet. That's going to explode in the air.
200.
So you got to think, the smaller it is, it's going to be an aerial impact, so it's going to explode in the air.
Why?
Which sucks, because it's broken up before in the atmosphere.
Does this know that?
Yes.
So, I want it to be like, it's past the atmosphere. This is what's hitting the air.
Okay. And it's got to make a ground impact.
Yeah.
So that'll be more like a nuke almost. So if you change it to 1,000 feet, that's good. And
Are
then
you
the speed.
Me? That's...
Dude, the speed? I mean, Amanda made it 250,000. Like, she set it to max.
That'll go through the air.
Let's start a little lower. Let's go to like
let's see what happens.
Let's go 50,000 first, right? Right? So in space, like, as long as something gets sent one way, in whatever speed, we all know, it keeps going that way, no matter what, in that speed. Till something it hits, or whatever.
Well, yeah.
So there could be an explosion in space that sends debris, and it's just going to stay at that rate, dude.
Well, yeah, until it gets affected by gravity and atmosphere.
Some type of gravity, some type of Jupiter that slows it down and pulls it into its orbit. And then the impact angle that it hits the Earth, which is, it could be straight down.
Let's just keep it at 45.
45 is good.
It's coming in hot.
Yep, 51,000 miles, 45 degrees.
It's 1,000 foot in diameter.
I don't know if you have to like select. You have to click you do have to click.
Hit Mechanicsville proper.
Okay. We're about to launch this one.
Don't hit Golden Beat. Yeah,
Mechanicsville. Yeah, there you go. So right where we live.
That's it.
Launch that asteroid. This is what's going to happen if it hits right here. Look at this shit. Boom. Not bad. Mechanicsville's gone. A 3.9 mile wide crater has appeared. The crater is 1,600 feet deep. An estimated 1,700 people or 1,800 people would have been vaporized in the crater. The impact will create a 0.6-mile-tall tsunami.
No.
If it hit the water. Your asteroid impacted the water. Oh, it says the water. It's wrong. What does that mean?
It's wrong. You're right about
that.
The
impact is equivalent to 17 gigatons of TNT. More energy was released than the world consumes in a year. An impact this size happens on average every 214,000 years.
So
who knows? Exactly. Who knows?
Dude, that's okay.
Well, there's craters, Jake. They could tell from that. And then the layers and then the dirt. 14,000. All right, so let's set it up.
Y'all are good and Golden Beach is good. I mean,
that's crazy. I mean, something has to.
Corner carryout's gone. Wawa gone.
No,
our work's gone. Yeah, work's gone.
Yeah, work's gone.
No, you guys are on the edge. You might have made it. Charlotte Hall was all right.
Did that shit say 1,600 feet deep?
Did. All I know is
that's crazy.
The water's not even close to deep enough to make that big of a tidal wave.
No. I think it's talking about if it hit water.
Had to hit in the middle of the ocean, like even if it hit the Chesapeake Bay.
Oh no, even if it hit there, you're right. Yeah.
Even if it hit the Chesapeake Bay, like the Chesapeake Bay is not 3,000 feet deep.
I don't know what the most common asteroid is. You know what I'm saying? So hold on, let me look it up.
Oh,
what's the most common asteroid? I got it. Oh. All right, got it. The C type, chondrite. They probably consist of clay and silicate rocks. I was like, what the hell? Asteroids range in size from Vesta, the largest, at about 329 miles in diameter, to bodies that are less than 33 feet. The total mass of all asteroids combined is less than that of the Earth's moon. Whew. All right, launch a big one. Let's see what happens. what's a football field?
100 feet.
It's just 100 feet?
I mean, 100
yards. 100
yards. 300 feet.
300 feet. So see, that wouldn't be that bad.
But if it's going fast.
Oh, okay, Amanda. 300 feet at fucking 150. Well, let's go 200,000 miles an hour. Just sanding it. Just.
What do you want to hit it? 100, like 90 degrees straight down?
Do you think more of a direct or
dude,
angled?
No, it would blow it out further if you hit it at an angle. If you hit it straight down.
Yeah.
Well, let's do it. Let's do 0 and 90. Let's do like 20 and 80.
21st? Let's test the same size at 20.
Yeah, 220 degrees, which is like, it should be a massive one-way crater. You know, it should be like an oval.
Okay, here comes Mechanicsville. Should be an oval. One more time. Oh, geez, look at the shockwave, 241 decibel. Everybody felt that, dude, all the way to Virginia. It was an airburst. It was an airburst at that angle.
Oh.
That angle made it an airburst.
Right.
Your asteroid blew up 1.7 miles above the water. Explosion was equivalent to 3 gigatons.
Had a shockwave, though.
Oh, it's because it was a 300 feet. It was a small one.
I mean, it was also going 200,000 miles an hour.
Look at the 0.5 miles wide.
Listen,
diameter.
I got to say, I'm not sure like a rock can go that fast.
Maybe.
Seriously, 200,000 miles an hour?
I mean, we can Google it.
You know how much faster that is than
sound?
Hold on.
Can an asteroid go 200,000 miles an hour in space?
Maybe with no wind resistance. Why does it think we're hitting the water?
14,000-ish, 48,000. While an asteroid the size of a house hitting the Earth at... never mind. Anyway. Yeah, we get the point.
Asteroids travel at 85,000
miles per hour.
That's cooking. But they have no wind resistance, right, in space or something? Because there's no wind in space or something?
We just don't want a big one to hit, dude.
Don't get that. This is so whack. I still don't
dude,
even know
because, why. Because like 0.5 miles.
Go to 90 degrees.
Jake, 0.5 miles in space is literally
straight
nothing.
Into the Earth.
It's nothing.
I know.
Think about 0.5. Think about like some kind of
about
Earth.
A half mile big asteroid hitting dead on.
No. Think of like two Earths colliding, right?
Whoa.
He tapped that.
Oh, my. Boy. That's a big boy. Man, I made a big one.
You made a half mile size bomb.
A rock. Your asteroid impacted the impact is equivalent to 308 gigatons.
Why do you think it'd be that bad if a rock just hit the Earth?
That's what it is.
I'm trying to figure out why that would be.
Like, people literally like spend their life devoted to figure out.
I know. I'm just trying to figure it out. Like, the rock hits
because it's going so fast.
The Earth,
Jake.
And then what happens?
Oh, what do you mean?
Like the rock
slams into
the Earth.
It goes through
Boom.
The atmosphere.
The Earth. I feel like the Earth would absorb it better than they think.
The smaller the rock, obviously, that it breaks up, but like the faster, I mean, yeah, it's gonna generate so much energy and just explode like a massive.
Ignore it is an option, actually.
But if the asteroid hits on land, there would be a huge amount of dust thrown up in the atmosphere. If it hits in the water, then there would be an increase of water vapor in the atmosphere. This would result in an increase in rain, resulting in landslides and mudslides. That would suck.
Do you think that it could knock us off our orbit?
It would have to be huge.
And if not, why
it would
not?
Have to be huge. And honestly, I don't know why. Like, I used to think about like all the nukes, all the energy. They were just boom, blow. I mean, what time are we at?
Oh, yeah. Patriot time.
1 hour.
We are at 1 hour?
1 hour, 1 minute.
Oh, my goodness, guys. That felt like an eternity, dude. Man. We were rolling.
It felt like an eternity.
So we love you all, and we hope you have a great week. It's Monday. Let's do it. Let's kick ass.
Anyway, let's to the rest of the Asians.
We're going to go on Patreon now. If you want to be a Patreon, if you made it this far, I should have said this in the beginning. If you want to join Patreon, you can join for $5 to $10 to $15, whatever you want to give. It's always greatly appreciated. Get mentioned in every episode. We love you all. And to all, a good day. Monday's rule.